move. Why is this place so dark? Where am I? And who am I? These were the questions intriguing a very, very young mind. Suddenly, he hears a voice. Good morning. This is the captain of your life. We have come to the end of the preliminary part of a very beautiful journey. It is the 13th of February, 1988. The place is Calcutta, and outside temperature is 15 degrees. It's almost sunrise. Sun, go and shine like the sun. And that's how fellow Toastmasters and guests was born. The eldest and the naughtiest child in the Mull family. Me. At school, I was always the lead actor in all the mischiefs. Until one day. So one day, our teacher was destroying our young minds. Yes, he was destroying it with boring history. Roman history, come on. Was I interested? No. Was I even listening? Of course not. Then what was I up to? Well, on my desk, there were two chalk pieces. The first one hits Khushbu, the prettiest girl of the class. She turns around, looks at me, and smiles. Yes! I am now fully charged up. The second chalk piece. Pick it up and it hits Ashish, the dumbest boy of the class. Ah! He jumps off. And two poor souls are thrown out of the class. The first one being Ashish and the second Akash, the innocent boy sitting right behind him. One more victory. Now I was looking for something else. Suddenly I see shoelaces. Two pairs. Not mine. I slowly get down under the desk, tie them together. 5 minutes later, the bell rings. The teacher goes out of the class. Bam! Everyone jumps off to laughter. Sumit fell. He almost broke his nose. Sorry, Sumit, I didn't mean to hurt you, mate. But it was good fun. In all this time, I never realized one thing. That someone was constantly looking at me from the window. As she walks right into the class, points towards me, and calls me out. That someone was a headmistress or Mrs. Freeze. And I froze to death. My parents were called. And you know what happens when dad gets angry, don't you? Well, on that day, he was a furious dinosaur. I was a changed man. I had shifted roles from being the lead actor to the scriptwriter, the director, and a cheerleader for all the mischiefs. I had learned the most important lesson of my life. Never, never, ever to come to the forefront if you are involved in some mischief. Sit back and enjoy. And in all this enjoyment, I never realized that my fun-filled high school days were over like a flash of bright light. It was time for me to say bye-byes to my friends, my school, and my home, and be all on my own. Life had taken a completely new turn, but a brilliant one. I was going to dreamland, Prince Pilani, yay! First day at college, I was at my best, you know, because first impressions matter, especially when someone's looking for love at first sight. But the small problem, my dreamland had girls. Pretty girls, lots of them. Vince Pilani had none. I know all my engineer friends out here can relate to my experience. I was sad, devastated, almost cried. Damn, stuck in this place for the next 4 years? And all I had? Lal Isbel, that's it. And really, apart from the female factor, all was well. Pilani is just perfect. And when you put a bunch of brilliant youngsters and give them complete freedom, things happen. Sometimes good, sometimes evil, and mostly crazy. So, you want to hear about the good things? Catch me after the speech. And if you're more interested in the bad, the ugly and the crazy things, I think you got to wait for some 10-15 years and you might find the book by Gunjan Mal. Okay, that's one of my goals. Coming to my other goals. Yeah. To play chess with the great Viswanathan Anand someday. For sure. And I hope I achieve that. In the next few years, go skydiving. Jump off from a plane, fly like a bird, and land like a hero. Well, apart from that, coming to my career goals. Well, though I have a very lucrative foreign job offer, I'm very keen on joining a good startup company to learn real business. Then do an MBA and gather knowledge galore. And then to start up my own business. So now you know. The next Steve Jobs will be an Indian. And he has just finished his icebreaker speech. Over to you, Christmas.
The goal to publish a book was an interesting one. Toastmasters, with this speech we have come to an end for the prepared speech session. We have seen how to control your stress and how to give effective feedback and a speech from Gunjan Mal. Now let's see how to eat out. Now let's break out.